reason because we want also to reduce that perception, people saying that our local indigenous chicken take long to reach market level. And indeed, when you look at right now, we have tried to do so, because earliest 5 to 6 months we are selling these birds, and earliest 5 months you're getting a first drop of eggs from these birds.
So what's the difference between generation one and now generation two?
As we can even see now, when you go outside there, our local indigenous birds tend to give us a very tiny small egg. But when you look at the size of the eggs we're getting from here, relatively bigger. And the production is also high.
This morning, I'm at NARO, that is Mukono campus, or Muzardi. That's Mukono,
Mukono Zonal Agricultural Research Development Institute.
There you have it. So why am I here? I'm here because there's something which is itching me. I have visited different farmers, and what I found out is the fact that we have so many local birds on market, but these local birds actually are coming from outside countries, countries like Kenya and those neighboring countries, and they entered into the local market of Uganda, and now farmers are calling them local birds, and you've seen them on my channel. But in the process, I also learned that at NARO, as a learning institute, they are cooking something for Ugandans. And actually, they are saying this is the indigenous chicken from our own soil. To start off right away, what are you doing here at NARO? And what are you guys cooking in here?
Here at NARO, what we are doing from here, we have cooked the idea of making this place to be a resource center for local indigenous chicken. How? We are doing a breeding aspect of this local indigenous chicken. Reason, because we want to maintain our local indigenous chicken species or genes. Reason, when you go outside there, you hardly get a pure local indigenous chicken. How? Very sure, you hardly get. Even these ones which we brought here, we had to take a blood sample to ascertain the purity of this indigenous chicken. Our local indigenous chicken has got eroded with these other exotic birds like the sassos and the broilers. So Muzardi, as an institute, came with an idea to make this place a resourceful for indigenous chicken. That's why we are breeding this. As we talk right now, we picked this parent stock of the indigenous chicken from 6 districts, 3 from northern, that is Gulu, Apache, and Lira. Then 3 from eastern, that is Soroti, Katakwi, and Serere. How did we begin with this? We picked only 75 birds from all these 6 districts. And we came here, we crossed the males from northern, mating the females from eastern. Vis-a-vis the males from eastern also mating the males from northern. That is the initial process.
Okay. Oh, interesting. So what did you come up with when you crossed them?
We crossed them, that was the initial stage, and we got the first generation.
Okay, first, is it this one?
The first generation is here. As you see, the size of these females.
That you got after crossing?
That we got after crossing the males from the other side of northern with the females from eastern, and the eastern with the females from northern.
So did you notice this. Any differences? Anything different from their parents?
We have really seen a very big difference in that at the age of 5 months, we were able to see that a female bird weighs 2.6 and above.
Okay.
And the male was weighing 3.5 and above at 5 months.
At how many kilograms did the other one weigh at that age?
The parent stock we brought when they are already 1 year plus, but a female was weighing 1.5, 1.4, 1.6. So you can look at that difference. Whereas the male was weighing 1.9 to 2 kgs. You can see now that difference.
Is it so important to keep, to maintain the local breed?
Very, very. reason these local indigenous chicken are so nutritious.
Are they?
Very nutritious. They give us yellow-yolked eggs, which are highly nutritious. Mm. And even some people want relatively tough muscle when you're eating, so that you feel it. Yes, that's why we really want to maintain our indigenous species of the birds. Mm.
Okay, so that's the problem you are trying to solve here.
That's the problem we are trying to solve. Then the other aspect is the egg production and the size. When you go outside there, our local indigenous birds tend to give us a very tiny small egg. But when you look at the size of the eggs we're getting from here, relatively bigger. And the production is also high compared to the other ones outside.
Mm. Did you really have to cross them?
Why we opted to cross, because we wanted to see if I, as Martin, has good traits, and maybe Madame
Frida
also has good traits. I crossed those two people to give us at least some good genes. So we now look at your offsprings you have produced, and we study them. Those ones who have gotten your superior genes are the ones we maintain, so that we keep getting a better breed. Reason, because we want also to reduce that perception, people saying that our local indigenous chicken take long to reach market level. And indeed, when you look at right now, we have tried to do so, because earliest 5 to 6 months, we are selling these birds. And earliest 5 months, you're getting a first drop of eggs from these birds.
Okay. Have you put them on market already?
They are. There are some of our out growers who have taken these birds already. And they are really testifying to us that the birds are doing well in terms of egg production, the weight gain, and even the growth rate. Mm.
You said how many generations so far now?
We have 4 generations so far, yes.
How many generations are you intending to stop at?
At the 5th generation, there we will have reached to the final destination.
Mm. The question is,
yes, ma'am.
Are you going to name them a different name? Because like you mentioned, we have Crayler's, Sasso, we have Rainbow.
Yeah, there will be a specific name which will represent the organization as NARO. It will be called NARO Chicken. Like the way we have seen NARO Cas 1, like cassava, how we produce those varieties. So even this chicken, the final seed will be called NARO Chicken. So once you hear one time a bird called NARO Chicken, just know that it is from Muzardi.
And it will be local?
And it will be a pure local indigenous, not with any exotic blood.
You know, there is a challenge we are facing as farmers. At NARO, of course, you may be knowing it. Like for certain seeds that have been improved, we are only able to plant once, and you can't plant that seed again and it grows. Is it going to be the case with this chicken?
No, it's not. It will not be. This chicken continue giving you eggs. So long as eggs are fertile, you keep on getting the offspring, so the chicks out of the eggs they are giving you. And the lifespan of these birds is quite longer compared to the other exotics. As we talk, we have birds of 5 years, 4 to 5 years here.
Really?
Yes. Mm. So the lifespan is quite long. Okay. So long as the management is okay. Mm. Yes.
All right. That's interesting. So I've seen generation one.
This is our generation two. You can see how cocks look big, really. You can prove it from here now. Yeah. Look at the size of that cock there.
It's huge. How old are they?
These ones, they have made 2 years now.
3 years.
Two coming to 3 years. You can look at these cocks we have here, and even the females, you can see it. The difference is really there.
So do you two practice not allowing inbreeding?
Definitely. Of course, in animal management, you have to avoid inbreeding. Reason, inbreeding always brings in high mortality in animal breeding. So you have to avoid that. That's why these birds are named. We know this one comes from this region, this one comes from this region. So we have the tags to identify them. So when we are crossing them, we cross a bird from a different region to a bird from a different region, not birds of the same line to made themselves know.
So what's the difference between generation one and now generation two?
As we can even see now, if I give, let me get this thing and you really take a weight of it, and you see. You can just feel it and see. So that is what we are looking at. We want at least even improve more than that.
What weight was it at? When it
5 months, we are able to get 3.8 and 9 kgs. That one there, 3.9 exactly. Then this one was weighing 3.5. Yes. Then this one was weighing 3 kgs. Then the other one was weighing 3.6. This one was also weighing 3.6.
And then those other improved locals, at 5 months, they weigh how many kilograms?
At 5 months, you find maybe around 2.8, 0.9, maybe some can clock to 3, there.
So you're telling me actually that this generation, our local birds were better than those ones?
Our local birds are better than those ones. So long as you give exact management that you're giving to the other ones. These birds are highly, very, very well, and they can really adopt the environment also very fast. So they're really very good.
Speaking of management, is there any difference between the way we manage these ones and other types of birds so that we can get?
When you talk about management, raising a local bird is quite cheaper and very easy compared to raising exotic bird outside there. Reason, these birds do not require so much attention in terms of drugs, keep on giving them vaccines from day one up to day last, no. Then these ones, you can even feed them like once a day. Just give them something little. You give them more of supplements, like what you're seeing around here. These leaves, yeah, and that is it. You're not supposed to give even more of these so-called the concentrates and what and the rest.
So what are you feeding them on? I'm seeing some Russian comfrey.
Yes, this is a Russian comfrey as one of the feed supplements. Gives them vitamins, and it has carotene component in it. So you'll be able to get your yellow-yolked eggs. Even if you feed them once a week, you'll be able to get yellow-yolked eggs with this vegetable roughage.
Okay, so their main meal comprises of what?
Their main meal here, we give them bran, broccoli, and soya, then with some bit of fish meal.
Okay, this is generation.
This is generation two, and here is generation three.
So I will start. What's the difference now, or any results that you showed that we are not maybe in the first generation?
Yeah, the egg size has greatly improved. If we happen to go to our egg store, you can see really that the egg is big like for that one of a broiler.
Are you sure?
Yes. We can even be, sometimes we even get double yolked eggs from these birds here. Yes. And the disease resistance has also greatly improved.
So in a month, this one bird is able to lay how many eggs?
We get approximately 20 to 25, because we are picking these eggs and take to the incubator. So per clutch, that laying cycle, you are able to get around 20 to 25 eggs.
And someone, like my viewers, they were like, the local birds, there's no way they can lay like 200 birds a year, eggs a year.
How?
They say that it's not possible.
Yeah, outside there, it is possible, because these birds tend to give us 10, 9, 8, maybe around 12. But for these ones, which are giving us 20 to 25.
It's possible.
It is possible. So that's one of the aspects we are looking at. Egg productivity and egg quality and the egg size. Those are the things we are looking at improving from these birds.
Can they sit on the eggs?
They have that attribute. Though for us here, we have the incubator where we take these eggs, but they also have the attribute of sitting on their eggs.
You tried it and it worked?
They do. Yes.
Because for the other types, the crawlers and...
They don't. They can't. But these ones, they have that attribute. As you can even see this one. This one is brooding. It wants to sit on the eggs. But now, since we are picking the eggs, since we do pick the eggs, so they have that tendency of wanting to sit on. So what we do with these ones, which want to sit on them, and the eggs are not there, we dip them in the cold water every morning. Okay, every day twice, morning and evening, morning and evening. In only 2-3 days, it forgets that habit and comes back.
As it's brood, will it continue laying eggs or?
No, when it is in a brood stage, it doesn't lay the eggs. Yes, it becomes dormant a bit because now it has to molt, removing these old feathers and brings the new ones, which are glittery, to attract the male bird. Yes, that's the behavior of the birds. Yes.
Okay, so you say this is the size of the eggs. I don't know if I'm allowed.
And even I think there are even those ones which are bigger than that. Yes.
Guys, you see? And they are a bit brownish.
They're a bit brownish.
They are those that lay white eggs.
What brings that is the feeding habit. No, this one is, they always feed on the bran mostly, that's why. But if you keep giving them the vegetation, that pigmentation changes.
To white.
To white.
So the only difference so far you realize from generation 1 to generation 3 is the size of the egg.
The size of the egg, the weight, and the growth rate.
How old are these ones?
These ones are coming to 1 month and, 1 year and 9 months. Yes. Because the other ones, these ones, then.
But this generation 2, they look bigger than generation 3. Oh, it's just me.
Slightly.
Because if you see the female ones, the females there look bigger than the females here.
And this one?
Yeah.
Slightly, but we are still working on that.
So your current worker is now at generation 4?
Generation 4, which is this side here. That's just a sick bay. In case we happen to get issues with our birds, we isolate it there. We manage all the sick birds from there. Of course, the farm you're supposed to have is a sick bay as well. So this is our generation 4. And these ones are young. You can even see the way they are.
How old are they?
If you want to look at that they are young, you can check from the spur of the cock. You see the spur?
This one?
That is a spur. You tell from here. The one which is having a sharp and a long spur, meaning that bird has taken some good years.
Okay. So this one is not able to fertilize?
No. These are the active birds now for fertilization. Because these ones are now around 9 months. Of age, so they are very active.
Wow. So what's the difference now?
The weight, you can see the weight, and even the growth at 9 months, and the cock is at that level.
Interesting. Why do they have those long necks?
This is just a bird species called naked neck. It's just a species of its own. And in most cases, these ones are resistant to drought. That's why they are like that. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Because you sourced them from northern, so. There you have it. You've been so worried, and I know most of you have been wondering the local chicken. So at NARO, they have what we call the indigenous chicken, the NARO chicken. Like you've heard, they sourced it from different regions. And so those of you who have been wondering, where is our local chicken? It's at NARO, okay? And of course, farmers will be able to access it with time, right? Okay. So stay put, this chicken is coming to you. Okay. Whenever you hear the NARO chicken, please go buy it because it's the typical chicken of ours, not from so that your worries are not, your fears are now settled. It's only found here at NARO because for the other species, they're not from Uganda. But they are equally good. There's nothing wrong with them as well. But you know, originality, home is always home. All right, thank you so much. If you have more questions, I know I surprised you with a visit at NARO, but if you have more questions, kindly leave your thoughts and your questions in the comment section below. If it needs be, I'll come back and I ask these guys again. But we also have a NARO team which will be answering those questions in the comment section below. All right, see you in the next video.